Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic hyperconjugation of propene. Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about the hyperconjugation of propene. And since propene is an unsaturated hydrocarbon, and we have also discussed about that the hyperconjugation are being showcased by the aromatic compounds also, as well as we could say that they are showcased by the unsaturated hydrocarbon also. And meanwhile, we in the previous lecture we have studied that the hyperconjugation are being showcased by the carbocation also. So now, based on this thing only, we are going to do a small example that how can we represent the hyperconjugation of propene. So let us talk about that. So let us represent the structure of propene, and after that we could easily determine that how can we do the representation of the hyperconjugation of propene. So let us draw the structure for the propene, that is. So this is the structure of propene that we have mentioned over here, and what we have to do is we have to do the hyperconjugation, and hyperconjugation is nothing but the delocalization of the sigma bond that has been present, or sigma electrons that are been present between carbon and hydrogen, as we could see. And here also we could see that there is a unsaturation, means there is a presence of the carbon-carbon double bond over here, making that there would be a hyperconjugation in this case also. So suppose if we are shifting or delocalizing the electrons in such a way that and that could be represented in this way, as I'm mentioning over here, that is, this is the two electrons of between the hydrogen and the carbon atom. So if it shifts over here, so obviously then we could see that the carbon will this carbon will have that is pentavalent, or basically we could say that this carbon will have five bonds attached to that. So that kind of the carbon is very unstable, so that is the reason we could see that even this two electrons, they will be shifted on this carbon atom. So therefore this is similar to that of the resonance that we are mentioning over here, and that is the thing that the structure that we'll get after it, it would be basically carbon, hydrogen. Here it would be the same as it is, hydrogen, and here there will be formation of double bond between these two, because earlier also as we could see that one bond has been present between the carbon and the other carbon over here, and even this hydrogen is also been present over here. But meanwhile this hydrogen will lose its electron, and that's the reason that it will form H plus ion, as you could see over here. And even this double bond that has been present within this carbon atom and this carbon atom, this will be converted into carbon-carbon single bond. The reason behind that is this two electrons will be shifted on this carbon atom, or the terminal carbon atom, as you could see. So making the terminal carbon atom to acquire a negative charge. So now this is the structure that we have, and the next thing that we have to do is, because here also we have saw that the carbon-carbon double bond is been shifting over here, so therefore there will be double bond over here, as you could see. So now the next thing is, again we have to stabilize this one, that is to stabilize this positive charge. So therefore we would shift this two electrons on the above one, and that's the reason that we could see the representation that is very similar to that of the structure that I'm going to draw, that is H C H. Here it was double bond and it will be as it is. Meanwhile the other one will also be at as it is, and this one will have the hydrogen and having a negative charge on this one, while meanwhile this hydrogen, which has shifted its electron to this hydrogen, and it will acquire a positive charge. So now this is the one that we have got a positive charge hydrogen, and that's the reason, so as to stabilize that also, this electron that has been present between, or the sigma electrons that has been present between the carbon and the hydrogen, that will be delocalized, and we could see that the bond of the hydrogen and carbon bond will be formed over here, and the structure could be written in this form, that is H C. The above one will be as it is, and the rest of the one will also be the same, having this one having a negative charge, as it was been mentioned here also. And meanwhile this hydrogen, as you could see here, this hydrogen will have a positive charge. So this will go on, this will continue, this will go on, and meanwhile if I would say that this so as to stabilize this positive charge, this double bond will come over here, and so as to stabilize this positive charge, again this two electrons that are being present in this carbon atom, they will shift over here and making the structure as it is, as it was in the first one. So what is the concept behind that? Is the concept behind that is the more delocalization that occurs in the particular molecule, that means the more the stable the molecule is. So therefore, if the hyperconjugation is more, then that will be the more stable product that we could get. So now this is what we have represented about the hyperconjugation in propene. So this is very similar to that of the resonance that we have discussed earlier also. And in that we have got to know that the more the shifting of, the more the delocalization of electron that takes place. And in that case, it was the pi electrons. And now it is the sigma electrons. So that is the two major difference that is between the hyperconjugation and the resonance. But the thing is, the more the shifting or the delocalization of electron would take place, whether it would be a carbocation or whether it would be a unsaturated propene in this case. So the more the unsaturation or the more the delocalization that I would say, then the structure would be more stable. So that is what I wanted to explain with the help of this example. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly. And I hope you'll share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.